Hi everyone, welcome back to USD in Bifrost. In the previous tutorial, we learned how to create an assembly using the USD point instancer. Today's tutorial focuses on material binding. I'll show you how to define materials and associate them with prims. I'll also teach you how to create different looks as a variant set with material binding. We'll start with referencing this USD layer, where the prim isn't bound to any material. Here's the structure of the stage that we're going to create. The parent prim monster has two children, geometries and materials. The prim geometries contains all the geometries that make up the monster. And the prim materials serves as a library where the definitions of the materials are stored. With this setup, we're going to bind materials to the monster's body, eyes, and sweater. So let's jump right in. First, let's create a stage. Select location where you want to save it. I'm going to name the layer Monster Material Binding. Get an Add to Stage node. Define a USD prim of the type X-form and rename the path to Monster. We're going to create two children for this prim, one for storing the geometries and the other as a container of all the materials. As we learned before, to create a child of a prim, we right-click at the port children, select Define USD Prim. Let's rename the path to Geometries. Change the type to Scope. Copy and paste this node and rename the path to Materials. Scope is the simplest prim type. It's useful when creating a structure that contains objects that don't need to be transformed, such as materials. Now the prim monster has two children, the geometries and the materials. For the geometries of the monster, I'm going to reference a USD file that I prepared. Get an open USD layer. Select the file monster.usd. I've included the download link in the description. All the compounds used in this tutorial are also available for download. Here we have the absolute path of the file. We can also use the relative path by changing the working directory to where this file is located. Here's how we do it. Go to the script editor. In the mount command window, type chdir, which is the command for changing the directory. And in the parentheses, provide the string of the directory where the USD file is located. Execute it, and now we're good to go. I'm going to change this into a relative path. This way, when we share a graph with other users, they don't need to modify this part. Right-click at Reference Definition, select Define USD Reference. Connect the opened layer to the port layer, and we see the monster. Right now, the prim monster doesn't have any material associated with it. To bind a material to a prim, we need to first define a USD material. Go to the Prim Materials, right-click at Children, under Create Node, select Define USD Preview Surface. This node allows us to set the path and attributes of a material. For example, if I want to create a blue shader, I can name the path Blue and pick a blue color as the diffuse color. Let's also create a black shader that can be used for the eyes. Change the path to black and set the diffuse color to black. We also need a material for the sweater. Let's copy and paste this node, rename the path to Textile Blue. Here we can provide a texture image for the shader. I downloaded this textile pattern from vecteezy.com. There's a link to their website in the description. We can change this into a relative path as well. Now let's take a look at the USD layer in the script editor. Make sure that shareable is selected so that we have direct access to the USD layer. Right-click and select Print to Script Editor. Here we see that the print geometries references the file monster.usd, and the print materials contains the materials that we just defined. We have the materials blue, black, and textile blue. Let's also take a look at the structure in the outliner. Here the print geometries had three children, body, eyes, and sweater. And the print materials also has three children, blue, black, and textile blue. Now we have both the geometries and materials ready. Let's see how to bind materials to prims using the node bind material. To bind a material to a prim, we need to provide the stage, the prim path, and the material path. Here's the stage. And for the prim path, if we want to, say, apply the same material to all the geometries of the monster, we enter the path of the prim geometries. Let's assign the blue shader to it. Create a value node for the material path. Copy the path of the prim blue and paste the path here. Now we see that the blue shader is applied to all the parts contained in the prim geometries. This bind material node also allows us to associate a material with a collection of prims. In Bifrost 2.5.1, we have a new node called Get or Create Collection. We can use this node to create a collection of prims. Connect the out stage to stage, and the path of the prim geometries to prim path. I'm going to name it Collection 1. If we want the collection to include, say, the eyes and the sweater, we right-click at Include Paths, select Fan In, and connect the paths of the eyes and sweater to it. Connect the outstage to the port stage of the bind material, and the collection name to the port collection name. And now the material is bound to the collection that we just created. The Get or Create Collection node also allows us to exclude prims from the collection. For example, if I want to include only the right eye in the collection, I can get the path of the left eye and connect it to the port Exclude Paths. Now we see that the left eye isn't part of the collection anymore. That's how we bind a material to a collection. Let's disconnect both the outstage and the collection name. Connect the outstage of the Add to Stage node back to the port stage. Let's get another bind material. This time, I'm going to set the prim path to sweater and the material path to textile blue. And we see in the viewport that the material with the textile texture is bound to the prim sweater. Before we move on, I want to briefly go over the binding strength. In addition to the default setting, there are two other options, stronger than descendants and weaker than descendants. If I set the binding strength to be stronger than descendants, we see that the material for the sweater is now the blue shader instead of the textile. That's because when the binding strength of a parent prim is stronger than its descendants, a child prim would always inherit the material that's bound to the parent prim. If we set it to weaker than descendants, then a child will have the material that's assigned to it instead of inheriting the material from the parent. That's how the binding strength works. Now let's change the first print path to body so that the blue shader is bound only to the body of the monster. To bind the material to the eyes, we follow the same procedure. Set the print path to eyes and the material path to black. Now every geometry has a material bound to it. Let's take a look at the script editor. Here we see that for the prim body, it has created a relationship between this prim and the blue shader in the form of material binding. Similarly, the material textile blue is bound to the prim sweater, and the material black is bound to the prim eyes. In addition to binding materials, we can also dissociate materials from prims using the node unbind material. For example, we can use this node to remove the binding between the sweater geometry and its material. Connect the path of the sweater to prim path, and we see that the prim sweater is no longer bound to the textile material. If we look at the script editor, we see that the value none is now assigned to material binding, meaning that the prim sweater doesn't have any material bound to it. That's how we bind and unbind materials. Now I'm going to show you how to create a variant set of different looks using material binding. First, let's add two more materials to the prim materials. I'm going to copy and paste this define preview surface, rename the path to textile red, and for the texture file, I'm going to select this red textile pattern, which is also downloaded from vectezi.com. Let's also create a red shader, rename the path to red, select a red color, and remove the texture file path. Connect these two material definitions to children. Now in the outliner, we see that the prim materials has 5 children, including the 2 materials that we just added. To create a look using material binding and add it to a variant set, I made this compound called create look. This compound creates a variant and gives it an appearance through binding materials to the prims based on the paths that we provide. And based on your choice, it either creates a new variant set and add a variant to it, or add the variant to an existing variant set. Let's take a look inside. It uses the add variant node to create a variant. If create variant set is selected, it creates a new variant set and adds the variant to it. Otherwise, it adds the variant to an existing variant set that we specify. To create a look for this variant, it builds 2 arrays, one containing the paths of the geometries and the other the paths of the materials. Then, iteratively, it binds each material to the corresponding geometry using the node bindMaterial. We haven't created a variant set yet, so I'm going to check create variant set and name the set look. For the path of geometry 1, I'm going to copy the path of the prim body and paste it here. And for the path of material 1, I'm going to enter the path of the blue shader. Similarly, we enter the path of the eyes for the second geometry and the black shader for its material, and then the path of the sweater and the textile blue material. Set the variant set prim path to monster. Let's name this variant Blue Monster. For the other variant, I'm going to copy and paste the create look compound. change the first material to the red shader and the third one to the red textile. Name the variant Red Monster. And now we have a variant set of red and blue monsters. Let's set the default frame to be the monster. And save this stage. By setting a default prim, we can later easily retrieve this prim using the node Get Default Prim when we open a USD layer. With this USD file, we can create an assembly of monsters with the two different looks. Here I have a mesh sphere with scattered points. And I've already created a stage here. As we learned in the last tutorial, we can use a Define USD Point Instancer to create USD instances. Let's reference the USD file that we just saved. To generate prototype definitions from variants, I created this compound Prototypes from Variants, which creates a prim definition for each variant. This compound is based on an example created by our software development manager, Guillaume Laforge. Thank Guillaume for the help. The example is included in the Bifrost USD lab pack. I've included the link to the download page in the description. There are many other examples in this pack as well. Now let's connect the scattered points to points and the prim definitions to prototype definitions, and we have an assembly of monsters with two different looks. That's it for today. So far, I've covered the basics of Bifrost USD, including creating a stage, defining variant sets, instancing, and material binding. We'll keep you updated with new nodes and features. Let us know in the comment if you have any question. Thanks for watching, stay tuned, and we'll see you soon.